Alright, so it's one where, let's see. Oh, Storm Kefka's Tower of Rubble. So apparently I've collected everybody. Of course I didn't train everybody up. I need to remember where Miranda is. Apparently there is Sabin's final blitz I can learn now instead of waiting to get to a higher level. Just gotta figure out where that is. There's also a taking Fagarl's castle underground one more time, and actually find a secret dungeon down there too. There's Miranda. So it's supposed to be Duncan's wife somewhere. I don't think this is him or her. Good. I don't think this is. Yeah. Lola should be in here, actually. Of course, I wanted to conclude that little mini, quest line. I would, bring Cyan here, but even then I don't think that's really necessary. I guess I can see if they have more reflect rings in here. Is there a relic store in here? I see there's a shield store, but not shield store, but store, that's what I meant to say. There's no relics in here. Falchion. So that blocks enemy attacks. Got some scrolls if I wanted to. Don't really need it. Swordbreaker. So this is supposed to be like a triangle. Maybe this. Maybe not this. There's also the death gaze I need to also encounter. The death gaze is flying randomly around the map, and pretty much the easiest way to encounter him is just to fly diagonally across the map, and then you should encounter him randomly at some point. It's a lot easier said than done. I believe I could probably kill him in one go, actually. Yeah, I'm trying to find the, looks like triangular forest patch to find Duncan's, little hideout. But I think I was supposed to talk to, Duncan's wife first before that happens, so I don't know. Maybe I should just go get Death Gaze real quick. Or fight Death Gaze real quick. So for the next however long it takes, I'm just gonna fly diagonally down like this. Then eventually I should run into him. If and when I do, I'll go ahead and fight it. Yeah, it's just super dumb. But it's pretty much the fastest way of getting it. Dang it. Apparently I can also get Gilgamesh. And Excalibur is actually the way to get to him too, so there's that as well. And let's see. And also, gil farming and regular XP farming is the best in the same spot, apparently. Where you fight the highest level of enemies, which I don't think I'm ready for, but who knows. So in the meantime, yeah, I'm still flying around. Hopefully run into Death Gaze one of these times. Maybe I'm tilted too far, actually. Let's tilt it a little less. I forget how many squares are on this map, but every square, again, it checks randomly to see if it will encounter Death Gaze. I wonder if I have to fly all the way up the highest point up here. I don't know. Because that's how I did in the past. I guess honestly, I didn't really need Phantom Rush because he learns at level 70. Man, this is a very long process of trying to do this. Again, I could fly around for like half an hour and still not encounter Death Gaze. I think because getting Phantom Blitz or Phantom Rush is not like mandatory. I'll probably skip that. Yeah, I can even... let's see. Search up how to find Death Gaze. It's probably gonna tell me the same thing that I'm doing right now. Yeah, it says there are 4,096 tiles of the map here. And if we fly over it with the Falcon, Death Gaze will attack me. Just fly around such a front, make sure that you watch your levels. Death Gaze will instantly kill a character whose level is divisible by 5, which I don't have any characters. I just want to encounter him once, you know? Like even more flatter. I'll do this for like another couple minutes. If I don't even encounter him, then I'll go ahead and do the Figaro side quest. Am I going parallel? I'm actually going upwards, I think. Yeah. Even better. It's fine. Easy waste to encounter Death Gaze. Some guy back in 2008 says, go to the cardinal map and then face a cardinal direction and turn just the tiniest bit, like 1 degree, fly in a straight line and you'll eventually get him. Jeez. I don't think I'm even halfway through the map yet. I just realized that the compass in the bottom right kind of tells us if we are tilting ever so slightly. And we are. I mean, here we go. Okay, so I don't think everybody or anybody is about to die from that. I don't think gravity works. I'm gonna hit him with bio. Let's dance. Let's use drill. I don't know why I used magic with a. Oh. Stumbled. Uh oh. I'm scared. Okay, that did not hurt us at all. 2000. He has 55,000 HP. So I gotta get in this damage. I think he's weak against fire. He's an undead type. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh. That scared me. He's an undead type. She's holy. Ah, oh, dang it. Yarf flew away. Let me dance. Alright. Let's heal. I don't know how much damage I did to him. Maybe 15,000. Kind of sucked. The flying continue. Oh, I changed my direction now. That sucks. Let's keep doing what I was doing. Yeah. So yeah, that's how you pretty much find him. You just fly diagonally like this, and hope you run into him. Because again, there's 4,096 tiles to fly through. I remember one time I beat him the first time I encountered him, but it's because I've been training prior to that. I haven't done that yet. Maybe I should have, but again, as long as no one dies, I'm okay. Probably kind of wants to try to grind in the one area, Dino region. But yeah, I don't even have level 3 magic yet, unfortunately. It's like very Western styles. Music's pretty nice. else can I look for while I'm waiting? Because honestly, I just want Ultima. I think once I find whoever gives out Ultima, I'll be good to go. Says I can get it from Ragnarok. Ragnarok? Where do I get Ragnarok? Oh, Ragnarok Magisite. Found in Water Ruin Narsh. You need lock to open the door. Teaches it at a times one rate. Also, the Paladin Shield, obtained by uncursing the Cursed Shield, teaches it at also a 1x rate. Okay, so if I want Ultima, I have to go back to Narsh, actually. Let me try to get this Death Gaze first, and then I'll get Ragnarok Magisite. And then I do Figaro. And then I'm gonna sneeze. Okay, never mind. I'm at least halfway through my flying search for a Death Gaze. And it's funny because it's probably always like the last possible square you can search, and you'll pop up. It's like my fingers getting tired. I'm gonna switch fingers pretty soon. Hopefully, not tilted too much. I should be flying vertically or just horizontally better, but I guess it's kind of the same. I feel like I'm tilting too far. I feel like I've gone around the world already a couple times, but I think I'm tilted too far. I probably skipped some squares, which kind of sucks. Yeah, pretty sure I've been around the whole map a couple times. I mean, a couple times, at least once. Sad is that I feel like maybe I'm still tilted a little too much. It would be pretty cool if someone made a mod that you can actually see where Death Gaze is located. I wish it was like a better visual cue on where he is, because this is very tedious, to say the least. Because I just imagine like this is how you would have to do it, or people have done it in the original version. I think it came out NES, right? Or Super NES? I'm just having to fly around like this. Would have been terrible. The real question is, what does Bahamut even teach us? So maybe it's not even worth getting. Though it gives us plus 50% HP per level. And it teaches us Flare, so yeah, the spell isn't that useful, but the bonus HP is. I think if I don't kill him this time, I might just move on and come back to it. May even do it off stream. What's also sad too is, like, if you can barely see the black dot where the shadow is of the airship, I wonder if that's how big the area of the ship is, so that, again, the game checks to see whether or not you land in the same spot that Death Gaze is. Because that's a very small speck. Yeah. Definitely going around the world once, and if I don't encounter it for whatever reason, I'm just going to move on. Yeah, I do have a growth egg. I forgot how else do I get growth eggs. I guess there's only one place where you can get the growth egg easily. And we already got it, obviously, but I think the rest you have to, like, trade it slash wager it in the Colosseum. But it's not that big of a deal to me. So pretty much if I fly around again and get to Kefka's castle down in the little red square, and I don't encounter Death Gaze once, then I'm gonna go ahead and move forward. You know, this theme song kind of reminds me of Wild Arms 3, back on PS2. I remember I bought that game because it was, I think it was Greatest Hits or whatever. Maybe it was just very cheap, but regardless, I bought it. Played like a good quarter of it, and then I stopped. But it was a pretty good RPG. I think I got stuck, but I wasn't sure what to do. And for some reason, I didn't decide to like look it up or anything, so I was just stuck. Then didn't play it for a long time. And then I finally got back to it and, you know, eventually beat it. It was a pretty solid game for what it was. Very definitely Western, Wild Arms. And yeah. I don't remember too much of it, but it was a pretty good game. Yeah, definitely if you're watching this, skip ahead. I mean, watch it on YouTube. Skip ahead so you're not watching me just fly around. With nothing really happening. Always this post-game stuff. It's not even post-game yet, it's like end-game stuff. It's definitely, long. Especially in the Final Fantasy world. Especially in the old Final Fantasy world. New Age Final Fantasy, they're kind of smart in which, like, you normally would end the game and then you can do the new game. Not even New Game Plus, but just post-game stuff. Because this stuff is just purely for completion status. There's really no lore attached to this. I guess the real question is, like, who came up with having death gaze? And then having to, like, fly around the whole map searching for the very unlikely encounter of it. That's just, harsh. Probably just wants to stop and go into Fogaro Castle just now, just past it. Yeah, should encounter it one more time, and then I can decide what to do. Oh, I realized that Sabin has Holy. Oh, speaking of it, Sabin. Let's do a Holy. Let's do a Holy. Let's do a Holy. Ah, it sucked. It's because I'm not a magic user. Oh, that sucked too. Jeez. Gonna kill you. Oh, that sucks. Why are you so weak? It's about to run away. Raging Fist. I've done considerable damage. I'm pretty sure I've done like 30,000, like total, including the previous fight. Just don't flee, please. Just take my damage. Just die. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for it. Just go for broke here. I don't care if I die. Maybe I do care if I die. This kind of takes away from my DPS. Don't flee, please. Just die. Yes! Just two encounters. Nice. It took 30 minutes. Not too bad. Get that Bahamut. Yes. I like that. It's just like random magic site flies onto the ship. Alright. Let's go and save that sucker. Alright. Bahamut is mine. Let's see what else we got here. Yeah, it's gonna take forever. Let's see. So I'm not ready to just straight up grind yet, so let's go to Figaro Castle. And get that, It's actually gonna be Odin. Odin and, other things. Down here. Go to Figaro! That's hilarious. I believe, yeah, right here. Shrub's unusually rough. Stop here. I think I leave through here. Nope. I think I have to leave through the dungeon area. It's not here though. where is the dungeon area? Here we go. I think we all know who really deserves to be locked up here. Mr. Kefka, it's on. Alright, so I still got that on. Big edge. Again, it's really nice that I don't have to like encounter anything. Just saves me so much time. Death Terot. I think that's for Setzer. Hi, Ithar. Monster in the box! Oh, it's a super Tonberry. I don't even know, I'm scared. I'm really scared. Let's haste all of us. Drill. Uh oh. Yeah, it's gonna screw somebody up. Okay, not as bad as I thought it would. I think he's counterattacking with that. I'm about to, he keeps counterattacking my attacks with, let me Libra it. Let's see, level 73, 12,000 left, weak against holy. That's the case, give you a Hadouken. Uh oh. Better use you to heal us. Do damage. Nope. Should be dead pretty soon. Wonder how much holy will do. See if he does barrier shift or not. No. Oh, it's gonna do something. Oh. I think snare is what auto killed. I forgot which enemy auto killed. Ah, barrier shifted. Darns it. Yeah, it should be dead after. Oops, never mind. Should have died, but... Oops. Oh, dang it. Crap. Alright, I'm just gonna auto-attack it, slash regular hit it. Excuse barrier shifting. Oh no. Now I'm healing it. Crap. Will the wisp do some... Nope. Looks like it's fire damage. Alright, do our non-elemental attacks, because this is getting dumb. I see he's actually moving closer. Uh-oh. Oh, no. I should really not use dance. Yep. Oh, we're dead. Oh my gosh. Oh, we're not dead. We're not dead. He's cheating though. This time, I wish I had a flare. It's doing fire, so I should be able to do ice. Alright, you're dead. Oh my gosh, I got really scary because he started using Quake out of nowhere. Okay. Please die. Wait, you should have been dead. Should have been dead. Oh, we're dead. That's so annoying. So annoying. Again, it's always good that you save every time you get a chance. Stupid things happen. So annoying. Should have won, but it's because I kept using elemental attacks. And I should not have. Especially because your barrier changed so fast. Alright, let's try this again. Again, luckily, we have the Moogle in our team, so we don't have to worry about. Encounters, so that's one good thing. Let's just pretty much only do non-elemental attacks. At least with the two brothers. And let's not dance with Mog, that's just dumb. Let's actually float everybody too. Because that is also dumb once he turns into. What do we call it? Earth elemental. Oh, don't dance. Don't dance. So it looks like he counterattacks with Traveler. Oh, guess not. So he's gonna counterattack physical things with Traveler. I guess not. I feel like it's also HP based when he starts doing stuff. He's about to die anyways though. Alright, we'll wait to see if he barrier shifts. Yep, he did. There's not chance it, so let's just kill him with non-elemental attacks. Excellent. Gladius. All that for a dagger. Alright. Oh, just a random dead end. Another random dead end? No. Let's push in. Magistat Shard, which I'll probably never use. Alright, let's go ahead and go down here. This should be. No. It's probably the Ancient Ruins. What is this place? Probably an ancient, oh, I'm sitting here without any noise this whole time. It's an Esper attack. Let loose our Espers. Well, that's like the first half an hour was, just me talking to myself. This is the site of a thousand-year-old battle. I love how they use the same sprites. Has he recovered from his injuries? Oh, we're talking about Odin. Doesn't matter, we have no other choice. We must leave this final battle in Odin's hands. City destroyed during the War of the Magi. City dead for 1,000 years. The city I had to seize for myself. Sentatsuken! Wow. Hey. Odin's power. That's some magi. Oh, you two? Nope. It did not work. Instead, Odin gets petrified. Impressive. I never thought you'd be able to turn me to stone. Crazy. There's a legend that tells of an ancient battle between the Esper Odin and a powerful Magus. It took place in the Great Hall of a castle. And here we are. Don't know if there's any special rooms. Oh, I guess there are. I'm guessing there's a dragon in here. There's whatever you are. And there's minimal damage. How is this drill to victory? This is pretty much our main strategy. because drill bypasses defense. And it's solely based on wow. Solely based on Edgar's attack or strength. $37,000 weak against poison. I'll use that knowledge to my advantage. Samurai Soul's power increases. Oh. Oh. Ah. What the heck? Oh no. Crap. Yeah, I really hate that if they're dead, then you can't heal somebody else. How much is this gonna hurt? Oof, okay, still very weak. Oh, he died. Died from poison, that's what I'm talking about. Poison. Ooh, got all the monies. Really go save, huh? Yeah, I should probably go save. That was a pretty hard battle. There's any other rooms here. Oh, there's one right here. Speak of the devil, Punisher. What does that do? Oh. Interesting. It's kind of like the rune blade, but it's a rod instead. Interesting. I'm assuming it casts or deals magical damage. Where's Odin right there? There's also nothing here. What? Pretty sure one of these should be a monster in a box. Nope. Cool hairpin though. Blizzard orb. Equipped to Yeti, see what happens. Ooh. Has MP. I think it's the same. No. It's not. What is these? This. There's a book encrusted with glittering gems. The Queen's Diary. I fall in love with Odin. It is a forbidden love, I know, but the flames of passion obey not rule or reason. Every time I think of that noble man, my heart flutters and fans the flames yet more. And who could rightly fault it? When the fighting ends, I shall tell him I must. And she never got to. She got petrified. So are we fighting you, Odin? Oh, guess not. Okay, let's see here. What does Odin give me? Meteor. Which is very slow to have. Or obtain. Maybe there's supposed to be something. Do I just leave and something happens? Wait, pretty sure something else is supposed to happen. They do that out of order. Should get stopped, right? Can't just grab and go. It's supposed to be something else that happens. So there's something else I was supposed to do. It says what? Stand 5 paces down from the queen's throne, or on the right, to discover a hidden switch that will open up a secret passage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What was this? And they'll open up a secret badge in the room where you found the X Ether. Probably here. Yep. Oh, we get a dragon. Looks like it's electrical or water dragon. Whoops, god damn it. I will see your tsunami with my That's what? You said exchanged? Acidurin. So now poison. Awesome. Honestly, I don't think I have time to even, like, see how much HP he has. Oh, he's dead. Yas. Alright, cool. Drop Santescu again. Ooh. The dragon's remains. It's like a Deathbringer sword. Oh. Even the queen was turned to stone. From the stone, is that a tear? Odin's mindset surges with newfound power. Odin becomes Raiden. And that's it. That's really anticlimactic, I will say. But now I can get out of here. I knew I was supposed to be able to get something else in here. Just didn't know what it was. It was like super hidden. But yeah, the queen looked hella young though. But that's just the way they wanted it. Alright, I can actually roll my save. I wonder if I can teleport out. I don't think I can, yeah, because we're underground, and I don't think it's set to teleport us back to Figaro. So I can just get out of here, normally. I think this way, actually. Yes. See how much faster these little dungeons are when you don't have to fight everything everywhere you go. Alright, get us out of here. Restart the engines! Of course, I need to go back because I need to get back to my airship. Take us back! Going. It's kind of interesting because you think because you know they're drilling through the earth, it would like you know create a big old gap so that you know it wouldn't be unusually rough every time. I mean, it'll be rough the first time through, but after that, it's do you want to stop here or not? Should be what it says. Oh, I don't want to go that way. This way. Alright. Go ahead and save. So, the question is what else do I want to do before I go on my big old grinding session? Oh, yeah, back to Narsh, actually. I do need to get... Wait, that's not Narsh. Narsh is actually over here. Silly me. Question is though, I believe I unlocked everything. I just gotta find... Especially some dude that's like dying somewhere. And I can grab... Two things, Ragnarok, and also Cursed Shield. I believe I want Ragnarok as the Esper, so I can learn Ultima. Or maybe I get Ultima regardless, whether I get the Sword version or the Esper version. I think I'd rather have the Esper version. I might have to go get... his face. Lock. I don't know if I unlocked every door. That's where I'm already getting nostalgia from revisiting this place. Okay. I need to get lock. Do I want to give up for the time being? Guess 7. Guess it doesn't really matter. I forgot to get the Moogle. Lock. Moogle. Celeste. Yeah. So I'm pretty sure I said out loud that I was gonna put 7 away for a little bit. For some reason I didn't follow through with that. This is the only house I didn't check. And of course, it's the one I need to go to. Hello, sir. Here, take it. Crush shield if only blah 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 blah. What about Ragnarok? I guess I have to look that up too. Let me talk to him again. I'll always lift the curse. Okay. Okay. But where do I get Ragnarok? So for some reason, it's not telling me. Oh, weapon shop back room. Didn't I already check that place before? Oh, I did not check this place yet. I've been waiting for you. I wanted to give you this. I ran a weapon shop for 72 years, but I've never felt a power like the one I feel in the stone. If I were to grind it down into the shape of a blade, I'm sure it would make a very powerful weapon. What do you say? I can leave it. So pretty much all guides slash, you know, things on the internet say, it's best to have Ragnarok the sword. Or no, not the sword, the Esper. So yeah. Apparently you can actually steal the Ragnarok sword from one of the final bosses if you really wanted to, so that gives us more of a reason not to make it into a sword. Also see there's a Vanish Doom combo we can be using. I wonder if there's any chance to I guess not. It would make sense if okay. I was gonna say it would make sense if you could actually I think next up I am about to initiate my grinding. So I don't think I need anything else. I just need Ultima. I have a rise. I have re-raise. I have all the good stuff. I just need to level up my crap. Right, Phoenix, what do you got? So here's re-raise and stuff. Let me see. AP grinding. Where do you want me for AP grinding? Well, it's apparently if I go to Miranda. Apparently Cactars are also in this game. Because they're in pretty much all Final Fantasy games. I don't think this is Miranda. I think this is. Well, I guess we can find out for sure what it is. Call you again. First of all, you're not talking to nobody. It's because it doesn't stay in the east side, does it? I love how the guy. This guy in this thread, he's like, first of all, you don't have to do nothing. Oh yeah. Let me check out the auction house here. Okay, here's the next item up for bid. I feel like Golem's just lost to us now, because someone bought it. I do not want this hero ring. This hero ring only like increases your attack and magic by 25%. Not that much. I'm gonna do this like one or two times. If it keeps showing me a hero ring, then yeah, I'm just gonna say screw it. I already lost the golem, it looks like. Besides, hero ring. Okay, screw it. I'm not doing this anymore. It is not worth doing this. I'm rich. Screw it. Give me that. So you can start trying to sell me this thing. 50k isn't that much. You know, I only have. I don't remember how much. Oh. 50k is a lot. Never mind. I take it all back. Alright, if it sells another hero ring, I'm definitely gonna be like, yeah, screw this. I only have 40k anyways, so. Yeah, I don't have enough for this. This is actually part of a quest line to get, to get a Gilgamesh, actually. I don't have this kind of money, though, but I wonder if they can sell it to me anyways. Ah. Not enough cash, stranger. Okay. Let's go and get out of here. Zozo. Well, this is Miranda. I don't think so. You can always check. Oops, Safagaro. I think I knew that. But. Yeah, this is Miranda. Yeah, this should be Miranda actually, because the desert's right here. This is not Miranda either! I'm getting juiced. Doma Castle. Velt Cave. Some house. Narsh, right? That's Narsh. This is Miranda, right? My gosh, where's... Don't we have a world map? So if this is not Miranda, I don't even know where Miranda is. Maybe it doesn't exist. It's not Miranda. I'm definitely being thrown for a loop here. That's the Phoenix Cave right here. Mage Tower. This wasn't. This was. Nicole something something. Nakia. Maybe it's here. That was Figaro Castle. Is this Miranda? I feel like I keep going to the same place over and over, and they're not where I need to be. It's the Colosseum. Narsh. The. Not Velt. I think that's the house that Gao. Gal's father is in. Yeah. Doma Castle. Not Miranda, I'm pretty sure. Gonna look at it anyways. Yep, I was just here a couple seconds ago. See what city this is called. Mobliss. is here. Finally. Jesus. I don't know why I've been so stupid. Alright, so not that guy. So I think this guy over here tells us about the cactars. Yeah, huge one attack. Oh yeah, I now remember doing this actually. Farming these guys. Oh yeah, sitting here like trying to encounter things, but I have the Moogle charm on. I'm down. Smite evil flows. Wow, 440 attack. Alright, let the AP grinding begin. Honestly, I should be boosting my, I think I can death these guys, if I remember correctly. Let's try it. Yes, I can. I'm gonna give you five. Five every time. Learn new dance. Not doing that, please. I think I want a healing one. Seraph, raise. Is there a faster one? Kiraga. Maybe this one. Yep. Alright. Be in for a long grind session. You're also dead, nice. That's a bunch of money, too. Cactar? Cactar. Probably the easiest way to... Oh yeah, drilling it. Bundling up something. Should kill it. Yep. Yeah, drilling it auto kills it because it hits it one shot. Or hits it regardless on evasion. I should probably put a gold hairpin for him too if I can. And he can't. No, that's fine. Alright, so it's supposed to fight like five cactar, and then a big cactar shows up. Yeah. There's a chance that I miss it, so I just queue up a couple of deaths. He just learned that. I love how the sim or like the Esper or whatever is a sword. It's kind of silly. Nice. Oh, I should also get Sniper Eye, probably. But drill's good enough. It's kind of funny because, you know, every time I do this, I grind forever. So you think I, like, memorize all these things. At least, you know, this particular thing. But I've had forgotten, so I look it up. Unholy. Alright. Probably get this. She's about to be done with this. Ooh, she does gain magic every time. Yeah, once she's done, I'm definitely going to switch over to getting Ultima. Too bad it doesn't give us any status improvements. It just gives Ultima, which is fine. What is her magic? 53. Yeah, so this is strictly to learn moves. When I finally go to grind actual levels to like max out stats and stuff, I will do that elsewhere. Tornado. Ooh, everything has been learned. Wow. Like, everything has been learned. Okay. Going with that Ragnarok. Ragnarok and roll. Let's have, this. Actually, let's do strength first. I mean, Bahamut's definitely valuable if you want to, like, max out your character's HP. Everyone's HP maxes out at 9,999. So. Nice. That gives no experience. Just straight AP. What I like to see. I forget which Esper gives you plus 30 MP per level. And that's pretty good to max out your MP too. Strength. Actually, I meant to look at the status of Edgar. 49. I think a good stat level is like 70. Whatever I'm trying to get. Usually it's strength or magic. I feel like you could kind of, you know, if you level correctly, you can split it so that they get both like, not necessarily max, but like high magic and high strength. Or if you like, deliberately keep your HP low, not HP, XP low, you can then grind these levels to specifically target whatever, target whichever stat you want. So that already upgraded his drill by a little bit. I want to use the tent pretty soon. Death ain't cheap. Granted, it's cheap if, oh, I could actually use a Soul Saver. Wherever it is. Or buy another Soul Saver, too. Let's re-raise. Alright. What else do I want Locke to have? Probably just Strength, right? He already has Bismarck, yeah. Seraph, MP, level 3, could learn that really quick, but nah. Guess Bahamut real quick. She's not gonna get any stat boosts using who's her face? Or what's its face?
Ragnarok.
It'd be cool if there's something that increases encounters. Yeah, I'm definitely not gonna do all 14 characters, for sure. Probably do like, well, definitely 12 of them. I'm assuming I'm not gonna use Yeti or Gogo, or yeah, Gogo. So I'll just skip them. Everybody else though, they're gonna do this grinding.
Grinding for life.
She's actually wearing the enhancer, and not the, Soul Saber. I'm feeling, Locke can't even use Soul Saber, now that I think about it. Oh, you can, actually. Not two wing edges is... nice. Are you on Ragnarok? 75% is any 25 more AP. Yeah, these battles go by really quick, so it's really nice that they added this in. Oh my gosh, I'm about to like get wiped here just because death won't hit. There you go. Let's get two wing edge. I should also put a sniper. Sniper's eye. Hmm. So that's okay. That only hits half the party. Oh, it hits everybody. Jeez. It's very scary to even try to refill your MP. It should be like one or two more. Well, depends if I get a cacti or not. Speaking of the devil. Oh. Oh. Okay. So it has super amounts of defense. So I'd have to use drill to really get the effect I want. Or just have Hawkeye finish him off. Alright. Nice, nice. Okay, now what else do I want for Locke? I think I just want... Well, that. Oh, how about you, girl? That's fine. And let's try to get Kiraga. So wait for Phoenix. Let's get that. All right. Before I continue, I'm actually gonna take another break.